The day of the Lord is a day when destruction would bring salvation, a day when mercy and judgment would come through a catastrophic event. And the book of Joel tells those who face this day's advent to repent and lament, and the Lord will relent. And this day came when God's presence and spirit brought destruction to Egypt, when God saved his people from Pharaoh's grip. In mercy, God heard the cries of his people, and he would respond in judgment to show them who he is. God led a plague like an army to bring Pharaoh, his city, and his crops under judgment. But Pharaoh would not repent. He wouldn't lament. So the Lord did not relent. Nevertheless, on that day of the Lord, God saved his people through the destruction of Egypt. Centuries later, in Joel's day, it seemed the roles of God's people and Egypt were inverted. Salvation and destruction were flipped. For God brought an army of locusts, a plague of destruction, against Israel instead of their opponents. Their crops were cut off, their livestock obliterated, their vineyards were dried up, their cities were decimated. The day of the Lord had come with a plague, and it was God's people who were devastated. And while crop shortages surely brought suffering in the physical, a heavy spiritual blow also fell on the temple. In fact, that was part of the plague's meaning. The locusts were sent as a symbol to show that Israel's access to God's presence and spirit in the temple was about to become inaccessible. So, as the people came to the temple, hoping to encounter God's spirit of light, all they had to bring was what the locusts left. All they had to bring was what survived. The scraps of food and grain left from the plague they offered as a sacrifice became a picture of Israel's future, when a fuller day of the Lord would finally arrive, and like Israel's crops, all access to God's spirit would be cut off, and Israel herself would die. If the day of the Lord was to be a day when destruction brought salvation, a day when mercy and judgment would come through a catastrophic event, then where was their salvation? Judgment had come, but where was mercy's advent? Why repent? Why lament if God already destroyed, if the Lord did not relent? God sent Joel to explain these events, that the day of the Lord that came with the locust was a foretaste of another day, and this plague pointed to it. For another plague was coming, a plague that the locusts could only prefigure. This plague would be a human army swarming like locusts, but their devastation would be bigger. Yet, the most shocking figure in Joel's whole prophetic picture is that God himself would lead the troops. God himself would be the army's sender. They would destroy God's house, the place of his spirit they would disassemble, and God himself would cut off his own presence with his people at the temple. Joel said that the day of the Lord was coming, a day of destruction, a day when judgment would come through a catastrophic event. So Joel told God's people that those who face this day's advent need to repent and lament, and the Lord will relent. So Israel did. They repented, but their repentance was only pretend. Their religious positioning was only pretense. They would rip their clothes, they would rend their garments, but God didn't want this show of repentance. He didn't want the priest's performance art. He wanted true contrition. He wanted broken hearts. He wanted them to come to him. He wanted them to fear. He wanted them to lament, to truly weep that the day of the Lord was near. For by repenting, they were not just admitting their sins. They were confessing that the Lord who was coming would bring salvation out of destruction. He would bring mercy out of judgment. He would leave behind a blessing, for he is merciful and he would relent. For them to lament meant they know God would hear them, that they know who God is, that he is long-suffering and compassionate, abounding in love and graciousness. And Joel said, when they believed this, God would respond to their repentance. Joel spoke of the plans God had for another day of the Lord that would come after this. A day when God would visit his people again. And this would be a day of mercy for God's people instead of a day of judgment. For this time, he would not come as a plague against them, but as a blessing that would dwell in their midst. What the locust ate, he would remake. What the armies laid to waste, he would recreate. But what would make this day of the Lord truly great is not just that God would pour out wine and oil, not just that he would pour out the harvest time rain. On that day of the Lord, he would pour out something different. On that day, God would pour out his Spirit. Access to God's presence would become unprecedented. The plagues of separation that covered the temple would be removed as God's Spirit came to dwell with his people. This was the day of the Lord, Joel promised, a day when mercy would shine through their judgment, when the destruction of their enemies would bring salvation through the most catastrophic event. And so Joel told those who faced this day's advent to repent and lament, for the Lord would relent. But as long as there was sin and people who half-heartedly repent, there would always be another day of destruction and judgment. Yet, on the greatest day of the Lord of the day would come and exhaust all of God's judgment against sin in himself on the cross. For on the day of the Lord that Jesus brought, all the plagues that ruined Israel would come and enact against him their priceless cost. All the pain that made the world suffer would cause him to suffer a final loss. For all our destruction and all our judgment was poured out on Jesus on the day when the Lord went to the cross. And on another day, on a day called Pentecost, the Lord would give us access to his Spirit that we thought was lost. For Jesus offered the sacrifice Israel could never afford to make. He opened up the way to God that was covered by our plagues. Jesus not only died to bear our destruction on that Lord's day, but he moved into our bodies because his body was raised. The Spirit of Jesus that Joel prophesied would pour out like a flood came out of the temple and into the flesh of those who trusted who Jesus was. And as they shared what happened on this day of the Lord, how Jesus was long-suffering and compassionate, abounding in love and graciousness, the people who heard were led to repentance. And as they lamented, the separation that kept everyone from God relented. God's presence descended, and access to his Spirit became unprecedented. This was the day of the Lord, when Jesus' destruction brought our salvation. It was a day of mercy and judgment because of the cross's catastrophic event. And the book of Joel tells those who live after this day's advent that we now need to repent and lament because the Lord loves to relent.
Hey everyone, I'm David with Spoken Gospel. Thank you so much for watching our video introducing the book of Joel. We are Spoken Gospel. We're a nonprofit ministry dedicated to speaking the gospel out of every single corner of scripture in every corner of the world. And we can only do that because we are generously supported by people just like you who give one time or especially who give a little bit every month to help us make free video resources just like this one. So if you like this video and you want to help us make more of them, just head over to SpokenGospel.com.